Warning, this show is real, raw, and unedited, and contains adult language and topics. Soul School Cafe has been known to open minds and blind eyes, so proceed with caution. Still here? Good. Let's vibe.
Who that is?
Sister. Let's cut it up, shall we? Tune in right now. Legend 107 Radio. That's what I do.
This is Kalam AC, spoken word artist from Newark, New Jersey, and now worldwide. You're listening to my girl Val Jones on Soul School Cafe.
Thank God for odd evenings in a world where people are needing more than what they're feeding on. I choose to continue seeding the minds of young and old with a little bit of jazz, poetry, and soul. Odd evenings are rather, let me say, unique. If ordinary is what you seek, then you've come to the wrong place, player, because that's not how I roll.
I told you I like my evenings
uniquely spiced with jazzitude and soul. Odd evenings. Pleasing, teasing, uncommon, and extraordinary, because just plain average is not in my vocabulary. Oh, the beat, cool as hell, I dance to the beat of a different drum, and when I speak, has been known to intimidate some, but I don't believe in dumbing down my craft just because some refuse or can't do basic math. I'll laugh when people think everything I do is supposed to be about them, but no player. These are my words, my verbs, my life and my journey, and for the 144,000 who yearn me, thank you for accepting and returning the energy, because I love these odd evenings with you.
And I believe y'all was in a group at a time.
Thank you for the music. Thank you for my life. Thank you for the good that you're in the right. Thank you for my laughter. Thank you for my head. Thank you for the love that I'm carrying. Thank you for my sunshine.
Thank you for my clouds. Thank you for making me stronger than I ever could have been without you.
Thank you for right now.
Soul School Cafe, the hippest, trippiest, most eclectic vibe in the cosmos. Soul School Cafe.
Thank you for right now.
I am. Self-awareness. Can we like pause on that for a moment? Self-awareness. Because we stay aware of everyone else. We stay aware of everyone else, but we don't quite pay attention to ourselves. What is it that we really want? What is it that we really need? I had a friend that said, first off, yay! Everybody good? No. Sisters, how you feeling? Brothers, y'all all right? So, what an amazing time we're in. What an amazing time we're in. In a matter amazing. Of weeks. In a matter of weeks, we've had, for the lack of a better word, a hostile takeover attempted that was aided by the government at hand. It's weird tricky shit. And we had somewhat squelch, I don't know. We've had threats, especially on black women. You know, we were told black women were.
Yeah, this show is a little deeper than the other shows. I'm a deep thinker.
18th, 19th, and the 20th,
I don't do shallow shit.
Which I said, you know what? If harming me is
my drum beats go
love,
deep.
I promise you, it will be
like
the
my
last
roots.
Thing you will ever get to love.
Ooh,
that,
for real.
That shit on your mammy and your pappy.
Hope
but
you
anyway,
that.
And
you
on top
for me,
of that,
I'm
since
for
you know
back.
We were given a threat to stay away, what happens? We have beautiful, wonderful, brilliant Amanda Gorman. Give
yes!
The best poem since Maya Angelou. At an inauguration celebration, where
and y'all missed it because you tuned into noon instead of 12 instead of 11:45.
Is sworn in
late
as
once again,
vice president. I don't give a fuck what you think about politics. All that shit was amazing. I don't give a fuck if you're a Democrat, Republican, Independent, whatever. If you vote, don't vote, I don't care. Just the dynamics of all of that was amazing. Amanda was amazing. She didn't get up there and sound stupid, look stupid, act stupid, or nothing. The whole stereotype.
And she didn't need Oprah. Oprah needs her. Let's get that straight.
Just the whole day.
Oprah.
And did you see Michelle and Barack? So Barack's done like a Leo. That's Leo energy all day. Just Leo. You think Leo is fiery and hot? Leo, no. You got that Saturn Jupiter thing going on.
He was stunting like my daddy.
When Saturn comes into play, Leo is just like, okay, all right. I'm gonna show you, but we all gonna win. I don't mean to say that we're all gonna win, because really, you know, what is winning? Who is winning? Are you winning in your life? Don't get so evolved. Don't get so involved with what is going on outside of you that you stop to pay attention of what's going on inside of you. Because I remember
you can't
when
fix
Gabby
the world
Douglas
if you can't fix yourself.
Just did the most amazing feat ever at the Olympics. And there was some motherfuckers that had the nerve to talk about her hair. Like, bitch and bro, what do you do then? What is it that you do again? You do what? On the street corner, you know how to determine, you know,
the self hate we have for black excellence.
Weed or something. I mean, what is your accomplishment?
But we'll apply some bullshit, some thought shit.
Number one, you cannot ride on
some dumb shit.
Number two, we all have the ability to be creative, but we all don't. So, shout out to the ones who have found their alignment, their path, their niche. Their glow up. We still have hard times ahead, but if you are focused on what you need to be focused on, I promise you that you will not end up dead like a lot of people will. I mean, you might, but you know, it's all up to you. It really is all up to you. All up to you. Anyway, welcome to Val Jones Soul School Cafe. Something I've been doing since 2007. I don't even know where that came from, what I just said, but you know.
Not right, this show.
I talked about her.
I've been doing radio since the mid 80s.
The first artist.
Yeah, I'm that old.
On this show tonight. Sis.
No, I'm that seasoned.
You made
I'm that experienced.
Because I'm not a poet.
In other words, I know what the fuck I'm talking about.
And Griot's sister. So proud.
Because I did it
Miss
in real life.
Amanda Gorman.
Not just for the grind.
On Val Jones Soul School.
This was excellent.
Mr. President, Dr. Biden, Madam Vice President, Mr. Emhoff, Americans, and the world. When day comes, we ask ourselves, where can we find light in this never-ending shade? The loss we carry, a sea we must wade. We've braved the belly of the beast. We've learned that quiet isn't always peace. In the norms and notions of what just is, isn't always just is. And yet the dawn is ours before we knew it. Somehow we do it. Somehow we've weathered and witnessed a nation that isn't broken, but simply unfinished. We, the successors of a country and a time where a skinny black girl descended from slaves and raised by a single mother can dream of becoming president only to find herself reciting for one. And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but that doesn't mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are striving to forge our union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colors, characters, and conditions.
We matter too.
Of man. And so we lift our gazes not to what stands between us.
You don't have to tell us we matter. We know
it. For us. We close the divide because we know
we shall not apologize for knowing it.
We must first put our differences
aside. We matter.
We lay down our arms.
We birthed you.
We reach out our arms to one another.
We fed you.
We seek harm.
We keep you in money. That's why it's called in the black.
The globe, if nothing else, say this is true. That even as we grieved, we grew. That even as we hurt, we hoped. That even as we tired, we tried. That we'll forever be tied together, victorious. Not because we will never again know defeat, but because we will never again sow division. Scripture tells us to envision that everyone shall sit
not
under their own vine
and our
fig
ourselves.
Tree, and no one shall make them afraid. If we're to live up to our own time,
you shall not divide us from our higher
selves.
Won't lie
in the blade, but in all the bridges we've made. That is the promised glade, the hill we climb, if only we dare it. Because being American is more than a pride we inherit. It's the past we step into and how we repair it. We've seen a force that would shatter our nation rather than share it. Would destroy our country if it meant delaying democracy. And this effort very nearly succeeded. But while democracy can be periodically delayed, it can never be permanently defeated. In this truth, in this faith we trust, for while we have our eyes on the future, history has its eyes on us. This is the era of just redemption. We feared it at its inception. We did not feel prepared to be the heirs of such a terrifying hour, but within it we found the power to author a new chapter, to offer hope and laughter to ourselves.
Where the old folks fucked up.
While once we asked,
greedy
how
bastards.
Can we possibly prevail over catastrophe?
Pedophiliac
now
bastards.
Now we assert.
Shiesty
how
bastards.
How could catastrophe possibly prevail over
but
us?
I'm the evil one?
We will not march back to what was,
okay.
But move to what shall be. A country that is bruised but whole, benevolent but bold, fierce and free. We will not be turned around or interrupted by intimidation, because we know our inaction and inertia will be the inheritance of the next generation. Our blunders become their burdens. But one thing is certain. If we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than the one we were left. With every breath from my bronze pounded chest, we will raise this wounded world into a wondrous one. We will rise from the golden hills of the west. We will rise from the windswept northeast where our forefathers first realized revolution. We will rise from the lake rim cities of the midwestern states. We will rise from the sun-baked south. We will rebuild, reconcile and recover in every known nook of our nation, in every corner called our country. Our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge battered and beautiful. When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it. For there is always light, if only we're brave enough to see it. If only we're brave enough to be it.
Miss Amanda Gorman, everyone. Oh my gosh, the queen was brilliant. That was brilliant.
And IG, and before you try to block me saying that I can't even air this, like public domain.
You know, when you're
because this is like a national treasure, public domain.
To
you're gonna put money on that? But
like
you'll show big booty
before.
Buddy.
Anyway,
you show boobs and ass.
Everybody knows about the
I see you.
Speech. Everybody knows about the I have.
And this
speech.
Is a real radio
but
show,
you know,
okay?
What?
From professionals.
Number one,
so we paid our dues.
Number one, it was a march on
all of that. So if you say, oh, copyright infringements, this is a real radio station. We paid the motherfucking dues already. You check out your map. You check out your receipts.
See, they don't want you to
because this year I'm suing every motherfucking body who steps on my feet.
Okay. One that the media
make
hates.
Me a rich bitch.
But you're gonna hear some of the speeches that maybe you've never heard, that maybe you need to hear again. Maybe you need to revisit your history yourself instead of just letting the media paint the man. because media never paints the entire black man or black woman as they should be painted. But you know, I do on my show, because our history and our history will stand forever, and we shall not be moved from our greatness. Let's go. Okay.